am Elliott, which stands for Laura Malone Elliott. And I've been writing a long time, first with journalism. I wrote all through school. Kids always ask me, when did I start? And I can't truly remember ever not writing little stories down. I discovered in my dad's things after he died that he had kept these very badly drawn picture books that I had done, which were, it was so sweet of him to keep them. But I think I amused myself always by telling stories and writing them down and keeping pictures to go along with them. I always tell children, I admit to the fact that I was really more of a tomboy than I was a big reader when I was younger. I did tend to carry books up into the trees with me, and if I fell out of them, I had them with me at that time. So I wouldn't describe myself as somebody who read and read and read and read when I was younger. And yet, I grew up in what had been my grandfather's house, and there was this incredible library in there. And it had all those wonderful classics, Robert Louis Stevenson, Treasure Island, the real A.A. Milne, Jungle Book, those kinds of great books. And nobody told me that I shouldn't be reading those, that those were boy books. So I really grew up with the idea of adventure and quests. Narnia series was something that I really loved. And I was also very lucky to grow up in what was once upon a time a small town. It's not now. It's been run over by the suburbs of Washington. But I happen to know a lot of people who were consummate and glorious storytellers. And they would often sit under the oak trees with lemonade and tell these phenomenal stories that were all about people and how people reacted to large historic events. You know, I think I learned right then and there that if you really wanted to appreciate history and what people went through during historical events, that you concentrate on how ordinary people could react in extraordinary ways. I always tell kids there are several things they need to bring to an interview. First thing is bring a tape recorder. Second thing is bring a notebook because your tape recorder may break. Bring a pen, it may run out of ink, bring a pencil, right? So have several things in your hands. You don't say, oh gosh, I don't have anything, can you give me something to write down with? Now, part of the reason why to have the notebook is not only that your tape recorder might break, it also allows you to be writing furiously, supposedly taking notes, but also making notes of, that made him uncomfortable, or I can tell there's another story right here, I'm gonna come back to it. It allows you to write things down without going, oh, gee, that's really interesting, because as soon as you put pen to paper in that way, the person's going to stop. You really must always have collected as much information as you can before you go to see the person. In other words, if you can, know where they served, if they had family or friends, you know, in overseas that they can tell you about. You want to know about their circumstances. Were they too young to have gone and fought in the war? Did they have, or were they old enough to have gone? You know things about their circumstances. I always write down about 10 questions that I would like to get to, knowing full well that you won't be able to go check, 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 check. You know, conversations take you in all sorts of wonderful tangents.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Anne B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.